Stephanie Simmer.
Sabine.
Also.
Stephanie noch nicht. Dann.
Oh gut, wir sind wieder eingezogen.
War nie mit Axel verheiratet.
With fashion, I always thought it's the thing that is in the future and then it claims that it's one gonna trickle down to the present. How far is that true?
I think the fashion industry right now is actually the one that is helping us to integrate wearables into garments. So it's basically the garment construction, the textile, the knowledge of the textile, the knowledge of the shaping, all of that is what is helping us right now to create fashionable wearables.
So technology refers to what? Electricity or what is?
Everything. Technology, I think technology as a term in terms of fashionable technology is not only electronics, everything that we know about physical computing, for example, where we deal with sensors, where we deal with microprocessors and so forth, but also deals with biotechnology. Like anything, like any type of chemistry, biomimicry and so forth, anything that is technology related or is regarded as a technology, but technology doesn't necessarily mean it's only computers. I think we need to probably think a little bit differently in the digital realm that there is another type of technology also out there.
So the fashion world is not only what I perceive the designs, but it's basically a motor to allow people to do research on those things. What research are you currently working on?
We're currently working primarily on materials. Different types of materials, functionalities, various functionalities, various sensor integration, miniaturization of sensors, using maybe the cell phone as a computer. We're working on different types of research projects that deal with functionality, very contextualized functionalities.
Mm-hmm. What do you call it, the third arm? What's the third arm? You think you coined that term today?
Yes. Well, actually, that was a reference from the audience talking about the third arm, like Stellark, for example, when he implanted basically his ear or his, like, you know, basically, what is it if, and in this instance, this comment was about the mobile phone being the third arm. Like, what if we lose that? You know, we feel like there is something amputated, you know, so we hope that the work that we are doing is basically so that you constantly wear it and you never really use it. I mean, you don't lose it, sorry. You wear it and you never lose it.
Okay. Show us one of the examples that you've been doing. We've waited for that. This is not pre-organized.
I know. We've been developing this t-shirt. Basically, it's using photochromic colors, photochromic ink, and you see the zebra outline here, and the outline of the zebra actually is becoming super, super purple the more it hits the UV light. So you create an interactive image through a static image in two different occasions. So the environment, the sun actually is the interactive color, I mean the interactive character, and it's the switching it basically to a state where you see the zebra and a state where you don't see it. And then all the different shades are actually using the different instances of the light. So the more light, the darker.
Could actually make geeks go outside again.
You could, yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, you're welcome.